Before we get started, follow along. Yeah.
It's from the ball.
As said, this week we're talking about the Aztecs and the end of an empire. And it all starts with this motherfucker, Hernan Cortez. Actually, his real name was Hernando. Like Fernando, but Hernando. But today they call him Hernan, shortened it up. Hernan Cortez. This guy is going to be the end of the Aztecs. But first, kind of give you a little background. He's a Spanish conquistador. He's going to come to Cuba, right? Be in Cuba for a while, for a little over a decade, making a name for himself, building up his property. But what he really wants, he wants to go exploring. Because there's tons of rumors about all this treasure and golden cities. But nobody's found shit yet. But the rumors are out there. And Hernan wants to be the first to find this. So anyway, Hernan gets good with the governor of Cuba. They're cool, but they kind of have an off and on relationship. And well, anyway, like I said, he finally gets the governor to go along with sending him on an expedition into the mainland of the Americas, right? Right off the coast where they're in Cuba, somewhere in the mainland. And right before he's about to take off, actually the governor changed his mind. His name is Governor Velasquez, if I didn't mention it. And the governor, you know, gets pissed at Hernan. He changes his mind, but Hernan ends up taking off anyway. And this is what he's doing by the very start, he's already breaking the law as far as Spanish law. He's mutinying in a way, right? He's doing something he's not supposed to be doing. He doesn't have permission from the governor who's working on behalf of the king. So anyway, what he does is he's going to take about a little over a dozen ships, or about a dozen, I think it's 11 actually, ships, 500-600 men, a little over a dozen horses, and a few cannons. They're going to kind of sneak off and make their way to mainland, America. And where they're going to land is right off the Yucatan Peninsula, east of Mexico, right? And one of the first tribes they run into. So this is kind of Mayan territory. But by now the Mayans aren't really what they were in the past. And one of the first tribes they run into, they meet this guy here, Guillermo de Aguilar. De Aguilar. And Guillermo is a Spanish priest who got shipwrecked off the coast of Mexico, and ended up in one of these tribes and was enslaved for a while. And, you know, was there for a few years. And so anyway, he's back with Hernan and with the Spanish. And the great thing about him is he's learned the Mayan language, and he can translate for Hernan. So he's gonna be his translator in this part of Mexico, or this part of the Americas. So anyway. So right before they take off, though, let me mention, Guillermo tells, you know, and not only Guillermo, but he's hearing it from others. Cortez is learning about, where's all the treasure at? He wants to know around here. Who's in charge? And he finds out there's the big dogs around here, the tribe called the Aztecs. They're kind of further west. So he's on the east side of the peninsula, and needs to get to the west side. That's where the Aztecs are. So anyway, so before they take off, what Cortez does is he burns all his boats. Of course, he takes all anything valuable on him, like the cannons, takes everything off, but he burns his boat. Like, why the fuck would he do that? Well, that's so his soldiers won't change their minds and decide to go back to Cuba. Nope, there's no chance, no choice now, right? Boats are gone. Let's might as well go and try to find our treasure and you know, and fucking change our lives and become rich, right? Well, let's see at least.